Simulation and Gaming. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Crowdsourcing and Gamesourcing, a brief overview. Gamesourcing is a new term created by combining a pair of English word games and crowdsourcing. The game is a game, but the explanation of crowdsourcing is somewhat more extensive. It is a method where a job, often very difficult for a computer but relatively easy for a person, is divided among a large number of people and depending on the nature of the assignment, either by common forces or by each one of them. In the first case, all participants will cooperate, with only the best of the other being selected. By joining with the game, we offer a means of making crowdsourcing on a slightly different basis. That is, players do not even need to know that they are doing any crowdsourcing at all. While they still enjoy it. The history and development of crowdsourcing over time and the gradual emergence of gamesourcing are quite new and young discipline. In the past decade, the new phenomenon, crowdsourcing, or the use of a large group of people to engage in some creative activity, is beginning to spread through the internet, for example, drawing ideas, content, or contributions, whether financial or professional. Usage can be virtually any: education, Wikipedia, research, health, transport, accident reporting, marketing and advertising, donation, volunteering, etc. However, even in the political sphere, the wisdom of the crowd has already found its application. After 2008, when Iceland was bankrupt due to the economic crisis, the creation of a new constitution took place, and its proposal was made available online for a wide-ranging discussion. By debating and commenting through social networks, Icelandic citizens could influence and correct the final form and text of the constitutional charter. The term crowdsourcing was first used in 2006, which could lead, due to the internet boom, to the erroneous assumption that it is exclusively an online affair. However, the process of using the masses to cooperate on a task has been working since time immemorial, starting with prehistory. It was then only the adoption of advice and recommendations by the chieftain from his subordinates, but in some way, it was some collective involvement in achieving the goal, for example, how to survive the winter. So, a certain form of crowdsourcing existed for tens of thousands of years before the emergence of the all-knowing medium, so basically it is not a new thing. Crowdsourcing has been used for some time already in architecture. In 1955, Prime Minister of the State of New South Wales, Joseph Cahill, announced a £5,000 competition to design an opera house on the Gulf Coast in Sydney. A total of 233 proposals were sent from 32 different countries. The winning design of the Danish architect Jure Utzon was the beginning of one of the most innovative and innovative buildings of the present era. This type of architectural competitions continues to be widely used. In 2006, Jeff Howe first used the term crowdsourcing in his article and had since become more and more popular. The first purely crowdsourcing projects such as Design Crowd, crowdsourcing of graphic designs, logos, websites, etc., or Dig, crowdsourcing aggregator of news, were launched. Also, crowdfunding has begun to develop, contributing more individuals with smaller amounts to the target amount to fund an interesting project or product. With the growing trend in the gaming industry, its potential for crowdsourcing has been properly estimated. The author Professor Luis von Ahn, Carnegie Mellon University, launched it under the auspices of Google. It was about describing images in a fun and catchy form. The number of similar acts has been slowly rising since then, and awareness of the gameplay has begun to be gained among the wider public. For example, in 2016 the Sea Hero Quest was also commercialized on domestic TV stations. It is a mobile device-based game to aid in the study of dementia. There has not been a year since the release, and the authors have been honored with excellent results. Crowdsourcing is so slowly becoming a part of everyone's life slowly, without being aware of it. Its special forms are called gamesourcing, where the means of collective cooperation is playing games. It seems that gamesourcing is on the rise. It has already proved to be an excellent tool in several cases. However, its potential has not been fully utilized by far.